Hi friends, hope you all are doing well. My name is Rashmin Keshwani. Welcome to my channel R&R Reviews with Rashmin. Today I'm going to share with you the questions that have been on everyone's mind and the answers to those questions. Like, we all wonder, why are some people successful and some are not? Why are some people able to overcome their difficulties while some are not? Why is it that some people win and some lose? We all know of someone who is facing a tough time. And even we, at some point of time, come across a difficult situation. How do we overcome it? Today I'm going to share with you how 12 principles and 10 commandments can help us come closer to our success and overcome all the problems. So, first of all, in the path of success, we always admire people who are successful, but we do not admire the hard work that they put in to get that success, which actually is the reason for their success. Secondly, there are certain things about my life that I cannot change and I need to accept it. For example, if I have met an accident and my body is currently weak, I need to accept it. Because if I cry, it will deteriorate my health. But if I accept it, I will try to take care of it and then work forward. Third, I need to take chances in life. So for example, nobody is going to tell me that, okay, this is the thing that you need to do. It is I who have to make that decision. And if you have not done that particular thing ever, take it and do it. Because there are only two things that can happen. One, you may do wonders at it. And two, if it happens on the flip side, you will learn how to do that particular thing. So next time when you come across a similar situation, you will be great at it. Okay. Fourth, in the process of solving a problem or overcoming it, we waste our time in one particular thing. Do you know what is it? Playing the blame game. So, if there is a particular situation that has occurred, I might blame my friends, my family members, my companions, my classmates, my colleagues, anyone. But in that time span of playing the blame game, am I actually fixing the problem? Or am I only wasting my time? Next, this brings me to the next part, which is sometimes our attitude is inappropriate. So I might cry, complain and crib about a particular thing that happened and why it happened to me and why did certain thing go wrong only with me and certain thoughts. Is this thought helping me in any situation to resolve it and is taking me close to my success? Is it, or is it taking me away from my success? Because the time that I'm putting in crying and complaining, I could have come up with a better idea to solve that problem and it could have taken me closer to my success. Okay. All this being said, I would like to give you 12 principles. The first principle is, if at all you or your loved one is facing a problem, first, do not neglect that problem. Sometimes we feel that the problem is too small to even discuss about it and we neglect it. That problem might just get accumulated and become bigger and bigger. Second, don't overemphasize the problem or don't exaggerate the problem. So for example, if I have failed in an exam and I think that this subject is difficult and I will never get it, or if I think that I'm less intelligent or there's some problem with me, or if I think that the teacher purposely gave me less marks, these thoughts are adding to the trouble that I already have and they are not helping me in any way. They are destructive thoughts. Keep a check on such kind of thoughts and try to distance yourself from them. Third, don't sit idle and think that the problem will get solved on its own, because clearly that is not happening. If I want to solve a particular problem, I need to get up, make a list of 10 things with which I can solve my problem and pick the best one. Also, nobody is going to solve that problem for me. It is I who have to solve it for myself or for my family. Don't get frustrated by the very fact that you have a problem. Because if, for example, I have met an accident and I get frustrated constantly by thinking about that episode of my life, I will ruin the situation and the atmosphere around me. It will add up to the negativities. Okay. Next, identify what your problem actually is. Some people struggle with not having money at all. Some people struggle with the idea of managing money. A student might face difficulty in understanding a subject altogether, and another student might face difficulty in remembering what he has understood. So these are two different set of problems. So, like it is said, samasya kya hai? Naam, naukri ke ghar. I am sure this will remind you of something. Okay, so understand your problem properly. Think whether I need to work on my managing skills so that I can save money and solve the problem of not having money, or do I need a job to solve the problem of not having money at all? Do I need memorization skills, or do I need to understand the subject better? Okay, in all this process of solving a particular problem and gaining success, there will be people who will add negativity in your life. Find out those people who add absolutely no value to your life and lay them off, because they are not adding any value. Why have them? Okay. This brings me to the next point, where you have to motivate yourself to take tough decisions. Most of our problems are existing because we are not able to take that one decision. Seventh thing, bait. Is your problem unemployment? If yes, what are you actually doing about it? If you have been recently laid off, and you have a time, see, it is quite obvious that after being laid off to my next job, there will be at least 1 month of time. At least. What am I doing in that 1 month? Am I taking up a new course and upgrading myself? Because I already have the experience. If I show I did absolutely nothing in that 1 month, it is not adding to my next interview. But if I present experience, along with an added course, I'm showing that I worked on myself and on my skills that I'm bringing to the new job. You are sure to get selected then. And this brings me to the eighth part. Before you date anyone else, date yourself. What would you do if you planned to get married and you had to search someone of your choice? You would go to all the places, all the applications where you could find someone who is also planning to get married. You would try to find out what are the qualities that they are looking for and what are the qualities that you are looking for. Right? And if they match, then amazing, kundli match ho gayi, right? That's exactly what you have to do for a job. Find out what qualities you have. Find out that what qualities a particular company is looking for. How many of those are you able to meet? And what all things can you work on? Use the extra time that you have got to sharpen your skills and to add certain skills. You are sure to get selected. Ninth, sometimes certain situations in our life add so much thorns to our thoughts. They prick us so much that we get shattered and disappointed. Think of it in the other way. If I do not come across those problems, if I don't overcome those problems, I will not reach my goal. One. Second, there are many people taking inspiration from you. If you overcome your problems, you are inspiring many others who have similar kind of problems. Be it accident, or be it an unemployment, or be it less marks. And you would definitely like to be an inspiration to many. That brings me to the 10th point. Sometimes we wonder, there are some people who deserve success. Some people who deserve the best in life. Yet, what is it that they lack? Because they are definitely intelligent, they are definitely competent, they are definitely smarter. But the only thing that they lack is a little enthusiasm. A little extra enthusiasm can do wonders for us. 11th, communicate. Sometimes we bottle up all our feelings, all our emotions and all our thoughts, all our problems that nobody around us is able to figure it out. Then who will help you? If I have a toothache and I don't tell about it to anyone and I suffer in silence, nobody will take me to the dentist. And the problem will get severe. Share it, because sharing can help you earn a relationship. But with that, I would like to add the 12th point. There will be some people around you who are ready to just add negativity to your life. Insulate yourself from these people. They will give you some unsolicited, unappreciated, unwanted advices which you absolutely don't want at all. Disregard those ideas, those advices completely. It will simplify your life a lot. Now, this brings me to the 10 commandments that can help you to reach your goal. Let's take a look at them. Sometimes we come across ideas and we feel that, should I even give it a thought? So when you come across an idea, do not reject it by thinking that there is something wrong in it. That's a very negative way of looking at any idea. Second, sometimes we reject an idea because we think that we may not get credits for it. Remember, credits can be earned later because there are definitely people who are noticing your work. But your human needs are more important than your ego needs. Third, never reject a possibility because you have made up your mind. Because if you are rigid to not change, it will only decrease your diameter. Okay, never reject an idea because you don't have the resources for it. Chalk out a plan and you will definitely be able to arrange the resources. Okay. Never reject an idea because it will create conflicts. So no matter how good your idea is, there will be some people who will reject it, there will be some people who will find flaws in it. But it is your idea and it is important to you to execute it. Never reject an idea because it is not your way of doing things. You can definitely adopt a different way if you want to execute that idea. So you need to know what is more important for you. Execution or changing your way. Eighth commandment. Never reject an idea because it might fail. That is so negative for your own self. It is like being your own enemy. Don't do that. Ninth. Never reject an idea because you are not sure or you are so sure that it will succeed. It's good if your idea is going to succeed because we need people who, from whom we can take inspiration. Okay. And there is one more commandment, and I would like you to go to the book and read and find it out for yourself. Now, having understood these principles and these ideas, how to work on a particular idea, there is one more thing which is very important, and that is faith. Have the faith that your idea will work. Have the faith that your problem will be solved or you will overcome it. Because if you don't have the faith, nothing is going to work. And then second, test your idea with everything that you have. It's negatives, it's positives, evaluate it and give everything to it. Your heart, soul, efforts, time, energy, commitment, everything to it. It is sure to give you your success. So, coming to the final takeaways from this book. First, in the process of overcoming a problem or of being successful, you will be criticized, you will be considered insane, you will be mocked, you will be made fun of. But you have to ignore all of that and just focus. Second, don't make any negative decision when you are at your lowest times. Because you don't cut a tree during winter. It is sure to bear fruits. Give it some time. And third, do what you feel is right. If you see some positivity in the idea that you want to execute it, execute it. It doesn't matter what people around you think, because it is your idea, it is your goal, and it is your success. You have to get it. Because tough times never last, but tough people like you definitely do.